Please note that the following video will carry very, very many spoilers for the series of Shogun. I definitely recommend you go ahead and give this magnificent show a watch first before continuing with the video. And I also will include a few spoilers for the game Ghosts of Tsushima. Thank you for joining me once again and enjoy the video.
You have no honor, and you are a slave to it.
When I finally reached the final episode of Shogun, my mind wandered to this very final scene in Ghosts of Tsushima. To see all these people in the show being slaves to their honor, slaves to their culture, and slaves to the lords that they serve. But what Shogun showed to me that beneath all the pretty clothes, beneath all the pretty traditions and rituals, the reality of human nature will always come to the surface. Brutality, death, sinister deeds, fighting for survival, the secret heart, and our very own goals. All of these things are covered under the guise of honor and order. If you really think about it and take a look at modern entertainment, we tend to generally sensationalize the medieval world, but there are very few shows which are able to completely capture the authenticity of every single aspect of it. It's not just fancy gala dinners and cool fights of honor. The show Shogun is able to encapsulate the entire picture of what it was truly like to live in these medieval times, capturing the beauty and the tragedy associated with this time period. If you thought medieval Europe back in the day was horrible, oh man, feudal Japan is on a totally different level, and they're able to express this so beautifully. For a society that is so well known for honor, it's interesting to see that by the end of the show, I ended up hating this very culture and even some of the characters that I grew to love. Shogun is a great experience that will definitely leave you with mixed feelings by the conclusion of the entire experience. And in my personal opinion, this particularly pertains to the way in which the show ended. Shogun is a show that is able to completely display a masterclass in subtlety. The culture is represented so, so well, man. And despite my personal gripes, the show was able to move me and make me feel a vast array of emotions that forced me to ponder over the show even days after I completed it, even motivating this very review. I'll be honest, compared to the average person, I've definitely consumed an immense amount of Japanese entertainment over the years, whether it's the many years of me interacting with the great and gracious anime community, or the multiple games that they've produced over the great many years, whether it's Kojima, Final Fantasy, and all these great developers, I've definitely had my share and dipped my toes and have a decent understanding of the culture. By the time I finished Shogun, I realized how ignorant I truly was to the intricacies of Japanese culture. But even beyond that, I was shattered to discover how fickle they view life and death. It gave me once again a grim reminder of how much people are willing to sacrifice in order to win. Shogun is undoubtedly the most authentic show I've ever seen in my entire life. Even as someone who was just watching the show from the comfort of my own home, I felt just as out of place as John Blackthorne, Anjin. This is an impressive feat. I simply can't imagine the budget that went into the set, the environment, the costumes and the weapons. Everything was executed to a sensational level. Every single detail was considered, and there were plenty slice of life moments that were able to completely hammer down this authentic experience. Shogun is definitely a slow-paced show. You'll definitely have enough time to stop and smell the roses, and oh my, they are so sweet. Shogun is not a show that can be faulted technically on almost any level. Everything was executed to a high degree, and a huge amount of money, time, effort, and attention was put into every single scene, every single piece of dialogue, and every single thing that happens in the plot. So the only actual area where someone can point out frailties or unhappiness is within the plot and its characters. Now note, in this part I will not be objective at all. I'll be making nothing but personal or even emotional arguments to substantiate my claims based on my own personal moral compass. So let's dive deeper into this. Let's start with my issues with the plot. What was the point of it all? By the end of it all, it was revealed that the addition of Blackthorn was completely meaningless and that Torunaga simply found him amusing. Quite an interesting role for a very important character in the entire grand scheme of things. Then Torunaga himself. He is seemingly established as the good guy in the beginning, but by the end of the show, I wasn't sure who I actually wanted to root for. I actually realized that I didn't want to root for anybody at all. Whichever party that was going to succeed in their victory, it was going to be bittersweet no matter how you sliced it. Even looking back to the beginning part of the show, Torunaga could easily have been established as a villain from a different perspective. Doubling your fief, taking the heir's mother. To be absolutely honest, the council was absolutely justified in their actions, if only they actually had noble intentions and weren't looking to take the throne for themselves. Looking at the entire journey that Torunaga takes along with Mariko, John Blackthorn, Yabushige, and all the individuals who worked towards keeping him safe, by the end of it all I wondered, was it worth it? What was the point of it all? What was sacrificed in order to reach these ends? Those who showed undying loyalty such as Hiromatsu, what was it all for? For your Lord Torunaga to succeed? I'll be honest, that scene with Hiromatsu was definitely one of the most difficult scenes to watch, closely followed by Maruko's untimely death. Because it showed to me that Japanese people are truly crazy, but more so that Torunaga was willing to sacrifice everything to achieve his goals. Considering Torunaga's actions, there was absolutely nothing that was too precious to sacrifice in order to achieve his goals. He is the definition of the chess player who's willing to sacrifice every single piece to win the game. But the thing is the prize really worth it? I know that of course even in modern times there are definitely people who would agree and would take similar steps to achieve their goals. But I guess it's true that nobleness and honor are things that are hard to find. Even from the ones who would expect to have it the most. An outer shell is just so, what you want others to see. When that final scene comes with Yabushige when he is finally executed for his treachery, I realized that I did not like who Torunaga truly was with his secret heart. I cannot fault the show on this. In fact, some people would even praise the show for tackling such moral complexities. I don't know, I simply can't quite put my finger on it, but perhaps I've become someone who's more of an optimist who wants to support someone who's somewhat honorable, someone I can truly get behind and their ideals. That's why by the end of the entire series I felt a feeling of hopelessness, emptiness, and characters that I love to bits being blown to smithereens. The characters in which I had admired the most ended up being the worst of them all, and then the character that I liked the most, Blackthorn, ended up just being a chew toy to be toyed around and played with in a game of elite Japanese politics. All of these ingredients coming together end up in a bittersweet mixture that comes to an anticlimactic end. Shogun, at least for me, by the end of it all, is a reminder on how much better humanity has improved in terms of how we view life, death, and honor. Shogun reminded me why I drew that moral line in the first place, and exactly why I'll never cross it.